Let's get straight to our reporter on the ground in Italy, our Milan bureau chief, Tommaso Ebhardt. Tommaso, good to see you this morning. You've got a whole new auto to chase after for the next 10 years of your career. What do you make of the deal?
It's very interesting. It looks like John Elkann is fulfilling Marchionne's dream to create a global car maker, one of the first three car makers in the globe. Marchionne's plan was to do it with a US car maker. John Elkann and Manley now are proposing a European one with Group Renault. Talks advanced very quickly in the last few days, and yesterday morning we discovered with Cersei that the announcement was going to be done today, and actually the announcement is even stronger than what initially we thought, because here is Fiat proposing a combination to Renault. So it looks like Fiat Chrysler is the active part in the process. Then we'll see what Renault would say. We have been hearing that the Renault is on board and is for sure in advanced talks with Fiat. This is going to create the third biggest car maker in the globe, almost 9 million cars a year. The two car makers will produce together. It's going to be a long way to the merger. What we can say now is that the combined entity will be based in the Netherlands, will be listed in both Milan, Paris, and New York. It looks like we are going into an European champion, which is also global.
Yes, and Tommaso, Fiat and Renault expecting their joint synergies to amount to more than 5 billion euros coming from areas such as purchasing power. Cost savings are one thing, Tommaso, but there have been falling sales in the three major regions. You've just talked about global, China, the US and Europe. And those falling sales is what's kind of brought urgency to the cause of consolidation in the industry. Is this merger, whenever it comes to pass, actually going to address the issue of falling sales?
Yeah, absolutely. This is clearly what in 2015 Fiat through Marchionne told analysts. This is a way to solve the so-called excess use of capital. Fiat has argued for years that car makers overspend about 2 billion euros every week in duplicating investment. In this way, they're gonna make savings for, this is what they say, 5 billion euros every year by combining the two car makers. You can have a share platform, you share the investment. They are saying they're not going to close any plants. We'll see.
What about the leadership, Tommaso? Because Elkann, who I know that you know well, he's going to be the chairman, we understand, of the new entity. Marchionne is gone. What do you make of the leadership, the potential leadership structure? Is it inspiring?
So in the statement we just saw, there's no mention, if I look at it correctly, it was very few minutes ago before joining the camera. We have understood in the last few hours that in the new company, likely John Elkann might become the chairman, and Renault CEO Senard will be the CEO of the new company. What I find interesting here in terms of leadership, it looks like this is a Fiat driven effort. In fact, it's Fiat making a proposal to Renault. We haven't done all the math on the exchange ratio. It would be about 50-50% joint company. That probably means that the Agnelli family Exor will be the single largest shareholder in the combined entity.
Tommaso, Renault's board was scheduled to meet this morning. Can you just tell us, in terms of timeline, what more to expect this week?
That's a good question. First of all, this morning we are expecting the Renault board to meet in Paris and to give a sort of a first review to the Fiat proposal. So we'll see what Renault board will likely say in a statement at this point after Fiat made the official proposal. Then there could be the Fiat chairman speaking today. He was expected to invent in Milan this afternoon. at the Bocconi University. It's quite funny that 10 years ago, the same day when Fiat announced the Chrysler deal, a young John Elkann spoke for the first time about it at an event at the Bocconi University in Milan, and today he is expected at the same university. So maybe this could be the first on the record comment.